G'day ladies and gents, welcome to War Thunder with Mags, and welcome aboard the MiG-15 Biz. Well, it's been a long time since we've seen this on the channel, isn't it? The last time I did a video on the MiG-15 Biz was my first impressions, which I did over 5 months ago. And I really didn't realise at the time that that was going to become my most watched video of any that I've ever created, with over 11,000 views. Now, first things first, the skin. It's created by Simplex, available on warthunderlive.com for the MiG-15 and the MiG-15 Biz. It's based on the MiG-17 Black Diamond Jet Team. It's a gorgeous looking skin, one of the best looking skins that I've come across for the MiG-15. I had to have it. And I think this is going to be my permanent skin for this plane. Now, while I'm talking about the MiG-15 here, I just want you to pay attention to the rate of climb and the indicated airspeed. This thing climbs like a boss. If you've ever been wondering how, you know, as an American pilot, you're in your Sabre and the MiG-15s always seem to beat you to altitude, you're about to see why. So why no Biz in 5 months? Well, really I haven't been flying them. I haven't been flying any of the top-end jets. I just haven't been interested, to be perfectly honest. However, recently that's changed. I've decided I want the top-level aircraft for every nation spaded. I'm skipping Germany, I already have the CL-13 done, I'm completing the spade on my F-2, which I did have once, but then Gaijin went and added G-suits and rockets to the plane, so I now have to grind a few more things to get that spade back. The Meteor F-8 for Britain, the F-86 F-30 for Japan, and of course the MiG-15 Biz for Russia. And this is by far the easiest one that I've had to spade so far. Now, I've spent a good part of the last week working on this aircraft, and it is almost completed at this time. However, this battle was one of the first ones that I flew, so it's very, very, very early on in the upgrades. And here we are, a minute and a half off the runway, give or take, and we're already passing 9,000 feet at 400 kilometres an hour and still continuing to climb. We've only just cleared the mountains on the outside of the runway. We haven't quite hit the river yet. Now, the true action of this battle is not going to start for a couple of minutes. The beginning of this match was me jockeying for position against F-86 Sabres and F-9 F-Panthers, but I just want you to watch how the MiG-15 responds. One of the first things I notice about this plane coming back to it is how smooth its mouse control is. Being fairly accustomed to how all of the Sabres, including the CL-13, handle, they tend to have a little bit of instructor wobble. The rudders and the ailerons don't respond quite the way you want them to, and it gives a really nasty little rock in the way the plane moves. Unless you're really, really, really tight on the controls with the keyboard, the plane will jerk around a little bit. The MiG-15 doesn't. And there's an F-86 F-2 demonstrating its burst climb ability in opposed to the MiG-15. The F-86 Sabres are actually both faster and have better burst climbs than the MiG-15 does, but they don't stand up to it in manoeuvrability. And you can see in that turn alone exactly how smoothly the MiG-15 responded to the turn that I put it through. There was no rock, there was no wobble, there was no anything. It was just smooth as silk. Now, beginning my dive down, the F-86 is faster in a straight line at low altitude as well, so even with this dive, I'm punching out over 1,000 kilometres an hour now. But you can see the F-86 F is easily pulling away. It's probably doing nearly 1,100 kilometres an hour. And this was one of the things that actually caught me by surprise, having been away from this plane for so long. The last time I flew this, I had no problem catching Sabres at all. But now they're quite difficult to catch. If they decide to run, you're going to have a lot of troubles actually trying to get them in the MiG-15, at least in this state of upgrade. So I see a dot pop up on my radar, I'm uncomfortable with staying at low altitude like that, running in a straight line for too long, so pull back up into the clouds and disappear. Time to reposition, see what else I can find. F-86F, closing in fast. Despite the cloud, I still seem to be able to see him with no problems at all. I'm not sure if he can see me. 737, slow banking turn, trying to close in. We've got another one low and behind. And there you go. Try and pull into the climb to follow him, and you can see he's actually outrunning me again in the clouds. He opened up the gap to nearly 2 kilometres. He was turning just as he went through the clouds. There he is again, trying to bring a nose around fast to see if we've got another aircraft in the area, but it's far enough out that I shouldn't have a problem. Just trying to bust through the clouds again. I've lost him. Where the hell did you go? And dipped the nose out, and he's actually opened up to 2 kilometres again. So despite the fact that I was in a dive, he just opened up the gap yet again. So there you go, the first weakness of the MiG-15 Biz. At low altitudes, it is slower than the F-86 Sabre. Pretty much slower than all variants of the F-86 Sabre, I might add. Now, I know what you're going to say. Mags, it's supposed to fight it at high altitudes. Yeah, well, you take the MiG-15 to 30,000 feet and try and find a fight. I play about 20 to 30 matches a day, and I can count on one hand how many battles that I fought over 20,000 feet in the last week. And to be honest, it's nice to see that the MiG-15 has a weakness. For the longest time, I remember this plane being faster, more maneuverable, more accurate on its weaponry, just better in every single way than the F-86 Sabres. It's actually nice to see that they have a definitive advantage now that they can exploit if they're good. Any Sabre pilots that have been having problems, there's your answer. If a MiG's on your tail, run. So just dropping back down below the clouds again, looking for a fight. I've got a whole bunch of targets behind me, not too many in front, although we have this F-9F. He'll do, and he's right in position and running slow. I line it up. First shot's missed. Now I'm running 600 meters targeting range on this thing at the moment with vertical targeting enabled to bring the 37mm and the 23mm into line. It does seem to be effective, however you do need to pick your shots. The cannons have incredible power, but not incredibly high fire rates, so you really need to make sure you drive those shots home. And here's the second thing that caught me by surprise. Maneuverability. I knew the MiG-15 Biz was maneuverable. I was not expecting what I got. No combat flaps, no air brake, and I am having absolutely no problem keeping up with this thing in a turn. I have deployed the air brake now because I was worried about overshooting the aircraft. He's just keeping ahead of my guns, and till then, first kill. Honestly, that was almost too easy. However, it has brought about one of the other weaknesses of the MiG-15 Biz, something you have to watch out for as a MiG-15 pilot. It is fairly easy to counter, but that is temperatures. The aircraft handles amazingly well at slow speeds, and is extremely efficient at fighting there. Sabre comes in from behind, just go into the vertical, it was going way too fast to follow me, roll it back over, and where the hell did he go? Oh, he's disappearing off into the distance. Oh, F-25, another F-9F, just loops straight up and over. F-25 has gone into the vertical, I'm going to have an opportunity to get shots in here. Come on, no, not quite, he's going into the dive. 260, and I'll just loop the plane back over. But yes, as I was saying, low speeds, why the plane handles incredibly well there, just deploying the air brake to arrest my speed so I don't go slamming the ground. So yes, low speeds, while the plane does handle incredibly well there, it will cause your engine to overheat, and it is hard to arrest. You need to get your airspeed back up after a short amount of time in at low altitude fighting. F-9F seems unaware of my position. Take the lead and take the win, second kill. Now I really want to get out of this furball at the moment because I do need to get my airspeed back up to cool this engine down, otherwise it's going to explode. However, I've seen another opportunity, an F-86 F-25, low altitude at low speed, so I'm going to make a move. Almost perfectly within convergence, and he just maneuvers at the last second, and I show how bad my shooting is. I only clip the wing lightly with one of the 23s, the main 37 shot misses. Air brakes extended, following him through the turn, and this is why you do not turn at low altitudes against a MiG, because that was too easy. Just get boomed by a 25, engine and oil have both gone into the red now. Yep, it's time for me to vacate the area and put some distance out of this fight. The rest of the team is engaged at the moment. I should have a window to pull away. I am worried about this one coming in behind for the boom. Pick high angle. He's turning back. Okay. Do I want to break out of this fight now? I might have another chance for a kill. He passes past. Nope. I'm not going to get him. F2 coming in. Air brake extended. Pull over hard. I do take a hit to the elevator. However, much like the Panther that I flew the other day, the elevator's gone red, but overall maneuverability of the aircraft seems to be about the same. Nothing seems to have happened. Now, I'm pausing the video here for just a moment because, well, this was the point where I made three critical mistakes in what I was doing, and it got me killed. Now, what my plan was here was to deploy my air brakes, reverse my rollover, and drop in behind the F-86 Sabre. Now, if everything had gone well, I would have wound up maybe 200 metres behind this Sabre in a perfect firing position to take him out. Now, the first mistake I made was I left the throttle for the MiG-15 Biz at 100%. I completely forgot about its very, very, very small spool time. What I should have done at this point, attempting this manoeuvre, was pull the throttles back to zero. This would have actually given the engine a little bit of cool-off time, and then drop down behind him with the air brakes deployed. But I didn't. Now, the second mistake I made is I forgot about the performance of the Sabre's air brakes. The F-86 Sabre's air brakes are vastly more powerful than the MiG-15s. They are incredible how much speed the F-86 can shed with those air brakes deployed. I have all the variants of the F-86 unlocked and almost two of them fully spaded now. I should know better. And my third and final mistake was the worst one I could have made. I misjudged the skill level of the pilot that I was flying against. I made the assumption that he would not be able to react fast enough to a drop-in maneuver in order to counter it. And that was the worst one of all. So I begin my drop-in, air brakes are deployed, point the nose down, pre-rolling to fall in his tail, the Sabre pilot sees me coming, pulls the plane up and rolls over and pops the air brakes. I've just put myself right in front of his guns. Take a short burst of 50s to the right wing. It doesn't do too much with the maneuverability. I am maneuvering hard, trying to avoid this guy now, but I've got a cooked engine. There's not much I can do. And then the F2 comes out of nowhere and just takes the tail off in a ram. And the F-25 pilot must have been furious because he had me dead to rights. And that ram also cost the enemy team the match. So, results for the match. Second place for the team with 3 kills and 1 death. Shadow Strike X2, Windstreak X3 and Terror of the Sky. 66,260 Silver Lions. And 3,533 research points. And that was my fuselage repair completed. A great first half of the battle, but what a way to end. The truth of the matter here is I got a little cocky. After 3 easy kills in the MiG-15 Biz, I got overconfident. And while we did still win the match, that was more luck than anything else. The F-86 F2 that rammed me cost him his own plane, obviously, but that left the F-25 alone with another fully upgraded MiG-15 Biz, and the one-on-one fight ended firmly in the MiG-15's favour. So why choose to show this battle? Well, 2 reasons. One, I wanted to show myself screwing up. When I screw up, I have a tendency to screw up big, and that's precisely what I did here. I was in a perfect position to take out that F2 and drop in, and because I got overconfident and I underestimated my enemy, the 2 cardinal mistakes of air combat, it cost me my continuation within the match. The second reason is this was actually a really good match to dispel some of the capabilities of the MiG-15 Biz. Even today, people still tend to talk about this plane like it's some kind of unstoppable force, but I'm hoping by watching this video you've seen that, well, it does have weaknesses, and you can exploit them if you know about them. Now, unfortunately, that is going to be all for this video. Unfortunately, work has pulled me in on double shifts, so the videos are going to be short and sweet, although I'm hoping I'll be able to make up for it next time. Also, a quick reminder to everybody, I do have a Facebook account and a Twitter account. I'm more active on the Facebook than the Twitter, but that's habit more than anything else. I have a tendency of posting up screenshots of battles that may not be good enough to actually make a video out of, but had an interesting moment up on there, and I like to do a bit of talk back in there if I can too. So if you're a Facebook user, feel free to give me a follow. Until next time, ladies and gents, fly smart, fly safe, and I'll catch you in the skies.